Good morning. Taking the conference further, I remember when myself and Mr. Kesar were discussing about the contours of this conference as to what we should do this time. This is almost 4 to 5 months back. We really thought of putting skilling as one of the pioneer areas where industry could perhaps be more competitive. I remember there used to be a film, there used to be a famous dialogue, and I believe the actor was Shashi Kapoor, who said, "Mere paas maa hai." Just to translate this, "I have mother with me." I remember when I joined this industry 26 years back, and I was very novice to the industry, and I used to ask, a couple of my friends used to come from apparel industry, and I used to ask them what they have in their factory, and they should proudly be discussing with me that they have 200 Juki machines, specialized Kaja machines, very good factory. And in this sense, this becomes very important when lately, you know, when I was speaking to Mr. Kesar 5 months back, and we talked to a couple of exporters, he said, "I have skilled workers with me." So see the stark change in 26 years. The machines have become number 3, and this asset has become the men or the women who works in the factory. My today's presentation is in this direction. I'll request Komal to help me out. This is a photograph, and Shyamlal is a driver, and he drives an Ambassador, the manual gear car. After some time, the owner buys another automatic gear car, but look at it, Shyamlal remains there. Shyamlal doesn't know how to drive an automatic gear car. You have invested into machine from 4 lakhs to 40 lakhs, but you have not invested in your driver Shyamlal, who remains Shyamlal. So unequal skill sets creates confusion. How? Shyamlal was a driver for the car with manual gear, subsequently made to drive automatic gear car too. Confusion. How to drive this new car? So despite of the fact that skill set for the both the cars are not equal, Shyamlal, or a worker in a factory, is made to run a machine. So confusion leads to delays, angry owner, "Jaldi chalo bhai, a conference ka time ho gaya." Lead to scratches to the car. If a 40 lakh car gets scratches, you get scratch on your heart. Similarly, and I'll come to apparel industry, we see signage as an apparel factory. This is a real signage I have shot myself. "Aavshakta hai karigaron ki, mobile number." I think many of you and many of our industry people are putting such kind of signage that we need karigars, we need workers. So can a different karigar, I'm take the same example, Shyamlal, can operate feet of the arm special machine like this? Who has just seen a model, I mean an embezzled model, or the hand operated sewing machine like this? No. I think the answer is no. So what we should do? Here is I have given the entire set of my printed presentation copy to Mr. Kesar, the DG of OGTC. But I'll briefly comment on what exactly the technical work I have done in this direction. So what we have done, you know, for the entire textile value chain, beginning from spinning and in the blow room, we have divided the trade names. If you look at it, just to name a few, mixing operators, lap carriers, apron joiners, contamination sorters. If you look the top ones, I have done some ratings on the skilling, what kind of skilling from 1 to 10. And I found that, you know, the skilling to the extent of 4 is required. But there are certain sectors, if you look at it, it requires more skilling, more than 4. Just go forward, more than 6. And so on, and so on. So look at it, the Shyamlal for the sweeper come fly gatherer has the high skill area, whereas the mixing operator, cotton mixing, is half of that. But still we call it a karigar. Next, please. Now I come to the blow room, the carding, the draw frame, the combing, the speed frame. Because these are the material which the apparel industry uses. And look at it, the kind of percentage of manpower and the kind of skill gaps are there. Once again, you know, the lowest, then come to draw frame, the 7, speed frame, and the others which are the higher than the speed frame, and these are what which require the highest skill set. And so on for winding and reeling. Next, please. So if you look at it, that in the spinning, training is required in all the trades where rating is 10, followed by the training which are lower than 9 to 1. Most of the composite units, they would be knowing better than me that if you really want to have a better production in spinning, your carding has to be better than spinning. But whereas you do in the apparels, you really don't go to that detailing. When you go to select a spinning unit, normally you go to meet a salesperson. At the most, you'll go to draw frame or a spring frame where 50% of the workforce works. You really don't go to carding area, which is around less than 10%. But carding is the area where you need the skill sets to get a better yarn, a better production. Next, please. So what kind of signage am I looking at the gate now? Skill carding worker required, skill speed frame worker required, skill ring frame fitter, card tenter, so on. So your signage at the gate should not just be karigar chahiye, it should be like this. A worker must know so what kind of skill set you are looking at. Let's come to apparel sector, which is close to my heart, and have done the similar analysis in this area. So the department in sampling, store, only 2 to 3% workforce is there, but look at it, the changes in their skill set. Storekeeper, I would say 5. Next, please. Merchandise is the 6. Trim quality checker, 8. Fabric quality inspector, 10. Go back to the previous one, please. Look at it. The maximum time you spend with merchandiser. But I'm not too sure how much time you are spending with your fabric quality inspector. To me, he's a highest skill. You need to spend more time. I've been hearing, you know, that he's busy with the merchandiser. But I never hear that you are busy with the fabric quality inspector or the fabric source. Though the percentage of manpower is very limited. Next, please. So come to cutting, it's the heart of the apparel industry. Look, the sewing room is 50% and cutting is 15% manpower is there. And look at it, the skill set, the ratings. The minimum 3, then 5, then 7, then the 8, then the 9 and the 10. Komal, you go back, please. Now look at it within the sewing room. You have three skill sets. In the cutting, you have 4 skill sets. But we hardly distinguish among the HR section. Next, please. And so on. I have worked for finishing, packing, surface ornamenting, ornamentation. Look at it, the kind of manpower, and look at it, what kind of gradings I have given to these areas. Beginning from 4 to 6 to 8, 9 and the 10. The final checker to me has to be the highly skilled person as compared to 4, which I give to washer helper. The job is to find out what consignment has become sea to air, what packing has not been done. Okay, last night the production manager was saying, you know, everything is in order, and within a span of 12 hours, I find that the shipment has not left, and shipment is on my account by air. And so on, and his day is spent like this. And how much time he gives to these areas where the skill set is 10? I mean, what is the performance? What kind of a production levels have they have given? What you are doing for changing from 4 to 10? I believe very less time. Next. So what we need to do finally, the industry needs to clearly identify break skill requirement department-wise, right job roles, right trade names, estimate percentage of manpower, put rating 1 to 10. I have taken an average of 100 units, but your unit could be a different. So you can put your own ratings, right occupational standards, and train the candidates for a particular trade. This is how, if we do this skilling in your particular factory, I am sure the productivity levels will go up and will be more competitive. So very quickly, let me tell you that there are schemes available where you can get financial support from the ministry. You get around 10,000 rupees for each candidate for training, but you really need to do your homework, which area you need to give training, where you want to take your people from 4 to 10 to effectively utilize this money. For a component 2, APC is seized with this project, so anyone, any exporter who wishes to know more about it is more than welcome to come to us, write to us through email, and we'll be able to tell you how to take the advantage from the ministry. Another thing which comes related to this is whenever you spend money on training, there are service tax exemptions available now. I'm just quoting a very recent circular from the Department of Service Tax, which is dated 10th, that you will be exempted from service tax if you use this money for skilling. So it's another area you're not taxed. 12.36% you take off straight away from such an event. So final slide is, in the skill set, factories should have all kinds of screwdrivers. Use the one which fits best in your case, and don't generalize the drivers since they are not equal.